Shoestring tackle right at about the 31. Here we go. Nonia is in the backfield for the Lancers. That's Nick Moore. Nick Moore on the slant has the ball in and out of his hands. Moore 0 for 1. Nonia is 0 for 1. Good pass right in the hands. That'll bring up second down and 10. All right, here we go. Moore and the Cowboy. Mason Vaquero on the right side. Vaquero in motion. All right, a lot going on there. Known as fake handoff. Jose Cabrera turns, hits the slant to Vaquero on the motion. Vaquero catches it and then stumbles in the backfield for a loss. It'll bring up third down and 12. And we got a DJ here, super loud. Here we go. The Aztecs now stepping back, had almost everybody on the line looking blitz. Untouched Russ from the blind side. Nona is pushed out to the right, caught. That's Isaac Meza, and that's the Lancers' first down. Nice job, Anonis, rolling out to his opposite side. Rush coming in behind him, untouched, gets the pass off. Meza with the grab. Meza's 1 for 1 on the evening. Hand off up the middle. That's number 22, Cabrera. Picks up 3 yards on the play. We'll bring up second down and 7. Nonez reads it, hits the middle, gets the first down. Nonez throwing, has a man, Nick Moore, into the end zone, touchdown Hilltop. That's a 46-yard pass, catch, and run. Hilltop strikes first behind the arm of Nonez and the hands and feet of Moore. Pablos, ready for the point after, kicking into this beautiful sunset here at Montgomery. It's up, and it is good. And just like that, Hilltop 7, Montgomery, taking the field on offense. Thank you. Pablos's kick into the end zone. First touchdown of the night for Pablos. All right, and a quarterback for the Aztecs, that's sophomore Andy Deonda. Some relation to Coach Deonda, probably. Pass is incomplete over the middle. And that's Grant on the defensive coverage for the Lancers.
Yeah, no, he's coming out.
You guys coming here?
No, we're going over there. They can't hear us at all on this side.
It's freaking loud.
Sideline, can you hear me?
Down here, all right, here we go. The Aztecs, three receivers on your left side, none on your right. Here we go. Handoff up the middle. And that's Grant that gets in there with his head to stop the runner. That's a first down gain for the Aztecs. Number three. Another run. All right, second down and 10 for the Aztecs. Deonda scrambling. Makes the pass. And the tackle by the Cowboy. Good for a first down. That was missed coverage downfield. They left their mark to go after the scrambling quarterback a little too early.
Texture on my iPad.
Deonda up the middle, another first down for the Aztecs. Here we go. Shotgun position for Deonda. First and 10 into Hilltop territory on the Lancers 43-yard line. We're going to have a false start. Number 75. That's Samuel Esquivel with the false start for the Aztecs. Here we go. Trip receivers at the top of your screen, solo on the bottom. Deonda, that shotgun, looking right, throwing right, one-on-one, wide open. Easy touchdown, Montgomery. And that was a complete burn down the right side on that coverage for the Lancers. That was number 8. John Ruiz got caught on the right side. And he was open by about 5, if not more, yards into the end zone. Montgomery, 1 point after away from tying this up. It's up. It's through the middle. It's good. And we are all tied up here in the first quarter. 6:19 remaining. 7-all. Flag on the play.
Thank you, ASU.
All right, re-kick. Nick Moore gonna get it at the 5-yard line, over the 10, 15. Gets caught up, gets out of one tackle, gets brought down about the 17-yard line. Hilltop will take over on their second offensive series, scoring on a beautiful 46-yard touchdown reception from Nonez to Moore for the first touchdown. Vaquero in motion. Quick dump to Vaquero. Nope, that's Isaac. That was Isaac Meza. Meza picks up about 8. We'll bring up 2nd and 2. All right, brings up a 2nd down and 2 for the Lancers on their own 2nd down and 3 on their own 24. Here we go. Vaquero and Moore out to your right. Meza to the top of your screen. Meza in motion. All three receivers on one side. Nonez gonna run up the middle. Nonez picks up the
first down.
How are you, buddy?
Good, you doing?
having fun.
Where's Dorsey? Next door?
What's that?
Dorsey, next door?
No, they went over there to the top because they couldn't, no one could hear him over there.
Oh, he's on that side.
He's on that side. There they are. See by the H?
Oh.
See you, bud. All right, here we go. Mazah Moore on the bottom of your screen. We're going to have a false start on Rio Nava at the top of your screen, number 4. Little juke with the shoulders and his hips. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us tonight. If you're a Hilltop fan and you haven't already done so, please hit that subscribe button. That allows us to keep bringing you live events. If you're from Montgomery, we're happy to be able to show you the game from wherever you're at. Here we go, Hilltop Montgomery tied at 7, first quarter. First down and 5 for the Lancers. Handoff, no! Nones keeps it, now throws to Mazah. Mazah needs to get upfield. He does. Kind of takes his time to get started. Little step, 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 and then burst into speed. A 12-yard gain for the Lancers, and that brings them to 2nd down and 3. Nick Moore, number 3, at the bottom of your screen. Mazah in the slot position. Grant in the game on offense, freshman. At the top of your screen. Looking right. Nones going down. Big rush. That's number 44 for the Aztecs. With the credit, that's Jacob Romeo. Jacob Romeo of the Aztecs with that sack. Grant headed out. Coming in, number 11 for the Lancers. That's Anthony Levine. Anthony, one of the transfers, had to sit out for that transfer portal window of time, which is basically 5 games, half the season. Here we go. Mazah, Levine on this side of the field. There goes Mazah to join Nava and Moore. Pass over to Levine. Levine's looking for blocking, and he's short of the first down. Same thing with Mazah. Took his time to get started. He was hoping that blocking would form ahead of him so that he would follow that blocking upfield. Unfortunately, it did not. And he had to take on a few defenders by himself. Comes up 4th down and 2, and the Lancers are going to go for it. Fourth and 2 on their own, 42. They need to get to the 44 of their own, 2 yards away. We're gonna have a false start, probably on the quarterback. His shoulder shrug. No! They're gonna call offsides against the Aztec, and that is a Lancers first down. Love it. Here we go. Mazah all the way to the top. Ball's on the ground. Aztec has it. And that's number 51 for the Aztecs that comes up with that ball. Mario Corrales falls on that ball. That was the exchange. Fumble during the exchange between center and quarterback. All right, Hilltop on defense, on their own 39-yard line where the Aztecs will start their game. Coach Deonda calling in to Deonda, the quarterback. Looking right, sidearm slung. Overthrown. He just dropped his shoulder down and sidearm that ball. Go, 25 yards. Okay, second down and 10 for the Aztecs. Ready flex on the left side. And that's number 24 for the Lancers. Adrian Mendez on the tackle. Mendez's tackle at the line of scrimmage brings up third down and 10. Third down and 10 for the Aztecs. 11 is Levine. 12 is Freddie Fleck. 19 is Roman Wall. 44 is Vinny Mancier. There's your front four for the Aztecs defensive line right now. Freddie Fleck gets in there, and that's a backwards pass out of bounds. That was a backwards pass, and the side judge calls it correctly. Yes, backwards pass out of bounds. Not an incomplete. I am happy to report they got that one right. Good job, officials, because the center official was not going to call that. Okay, Aztecs ready to punt. Back for the Lancers, number 4, Rio Nava. Punts up way over to the left side, Shank. And that's the Aztecs, number 24 on the punt. That's Jaden Cannon. Jaden Cannon got a shank there. He knows it, he sees it himself. Goes out of bounds. Where are the Lancers? We'll start first and 10 at their 30-yard line. We are in the first quarter. It is 7-7, all tied up. Lancers scored on their very first drive, 46-yard touchdown, pass, reception, and run, known as two more. Aztecs scored on their first drive, 41-yard pass and run, and then neither team scored on their second. Here we go, third drive starting for the Aztecs. Quick pass over the middle. Nones to Nava. Nava pulls that in. And that's a first down for the Lancers. All right, moving the chains. We are first and 10 on the 45 of the Lancers. Hilltop on the bottom of your screen here. Number 3, Nick Moore. Number 2, Mason Vaquero. Number 7, Isaac Meza. And at the top of your screen, Rio Nava. That was the play they tried to run that fumbled. Nones lost it 2 yards. Here we go. Second and 12. Mason Vaquero in motion. Roll out to that side. Rush from behind. Pass across the middle. Rio Nava, 2 for 2 tonight. That's what that young man needs. Build that confidence. And that's another first down. Both catches in traffic. Nice job, Mr. Nava. And we are end of the first quarter, tie game 7-7. Go, Once again, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us for our broadcast. If you're from Hilltop, always glad to have you. If you have not subscribed, please go ahead and hit that subscription button. It is free. Those subscriptions help us keep you live. If you're from Montgomery, we just ask that you enjoy. Have a great time. And if you're joining us from somewhere, go ahead and chat it on in. We can have a conversation here on the air. Here we go. First and 10 for the Lancers, known as In Shotgun. That's Meza in motion. And nope. And Nones throws the ball. What's that? They're over there because they can't. Are you here for filming or for talking?
Like filming, but during the game. It's like silent.
Yeah, go ahead. You can set up or they can go upstairs, but you're not getting upstairs.
There's no outlets here?
They can't talk on their headsets. It wasn't picking up over here.
Okay.
Anna Marino. Hi, Anna. Hope you're enjoying retirement. We're jealous. All right, second and 15. Hilltop might have got away with something there. That looked like a backwards pass. Cabral in and out of his hands. As we're saying, that first pass might have been backwards. Should have been an open ball, ready for a fumble, or ready for a recovery. Montgomery was there, but the center official called the ball dead. Can't do anything about it now. All right. All right. Carolyn joining us from some area that we can't pronounce. Starts with an A. Watching the Cowboy. Mesa Vaquero. Here we go. Third down. He's going to try to cut. He is in all sorts of traffic and does not even get back to the original line of scrimmage. That'll bring up fourth down and 13, and here comes the punting crew for the Lancers. All right. Pablos set to punt for the Lancers. Long snapper, that looks like Grant. Is that Grant long snapping? The freshman?
Yes.
That young man's all over the place. On defense, receiver on offense. And it wasn't Pablos back to punt. It was Nones. Nones goes for the pass, throws the interception. There's a flag afterwards at the end of the play. So anyways, Grant was the long snapper there. Young man, impressive. Playing cornerback, playing wide receiver, long snapping. Nones. Did he throw it from 1 foot, like almost jumping in the air? Did not need to do that. Did not have anybody on him. Set his feet and get a good throw. We're going to have a personal foul against Montgomery after that play. Probably celebration. So, that's one of the knocks on both quarterbacks. Mainly known as he does it a lot. He's trying to get fancy and throw that ball on the run when he doesn't need to throw it on the run. Jumps in the air when he throws it when he doesn't need to. He will work on that. He'll get that strong. Got the arm. Now he needs to just get those fundamentals there. All right, on defense. Deonda at quarterback, shotgun. And we're going to have a timeout. All right, so that was the fastest timeout I've ever seen, just to get that substitution there. Wasted timeout because the person wasn't lined up the way they were. We got a flag in the deep backfield on the Montgomery side. I have to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, the sideline for Montgomery does not look packed with players. When you see a high school sideline, you usually see three times that amount of players. All right, that penalty's against the Aztecs. It's going to walk it back, and it is now first down and 20 for the Aztecs. Back on their own, 23.
Could you give it to Coach Tommy? It's set up. Both of you guys should be able to connect to the sideline now. Up to you, whatever you're more comfortable with. But you can connect to the sideline right now, and then you can connect to the top. Just make sure he's connected.
Do you guys get to get the feed off of that camera too?
I think they have NFHS, so I don't think so.
Or they could just go to YouTube and get it for you right there. Okay. Oh, now that I got
it. Real deal.
Beauty
player. Yeah. Should have just done that. It's a cool little gadget to have, though. How long have you been announcing for?
Since Lincoln left, so yeah. At least a decade. Pass deep down the left side, and that ball just floated into number one's hands. Talias Garcia. Grant is down. Okay, so I have a vendor for you. See if I can find it right here. Here we go. Aztecs, first and 10, Lancer territory on the 48. Deonda throws it out of bounds. Solid rush by the Lancers. Thank you. This is our girls' flag football jersey. But that H is going to go, it's turned to this H because I don't want the Hawaiian H on there. Anyways, they're reversible. So on the inside, they're white, exact same, but white.
Okay.
They're dry, the normal dry fit shirt that you wear for pre-game shooting shoot-arounds.
Oh, yeah.
But it's two dry fits stitched together for a reversible, so you wear it home and away.
So I could do like a black and white one?
You could do black and pink, black and white.
That's they're, fresh.
If you do 100, they're $35 each. If you do less than 100, they're 40 each. But if you think about it, most dry fits now, these are sublimation, so yeah. It's not screen print. It's actually in the jersey. So you're basically getting it for $20 each. Since it's a reversible.
That's not bad at all.
No. And the guy can do them with sleeves, he can do them with sleeveless, he can do them with tank top, jerseys.
Yeah.
You do you can do jerseys, does them all. He's big into the flag football scene, but he's now branching out to all of the sports.
Yeah, so,
and so he does tank tops.
Put our jerseys like on the seats for pregame, and then we just have like warm-ups on. So that
that's what
perfect.
We do for soccer, or we did when I was there.
Yeah,
baseball does the same thing. All right, running. So you have your phone. Go to Instagram. Timmy J, T-I-M-M-E. J, design.
Okay.
And just start scanning through his pictures. And those are the different.
Oh yeah, the pink is fresh too.
And anything you want to design.
So they can be fitted?
Fitted, you do anything. He makes them from scratch.
Oh yeah, this has to be full sublimation too. This is
yep.
So fresh. Oh,
he also does.
Okay.
Yeah, he did the Mar Vistas ones. And he also does, sleeveless with a hood. A hoodie sleeveless. But all sorts of stuff.
Oh yeah, I like this. I'm for sure gonna know. And he already did your jerseys and stuff too?
That's our mock-up. We're ordering them right now and he's doing baseball right now.
40 of
these? So you're basically getting two for 40.
Oh, he's full on jumpsuits too.
Oh, he does everything. Shorts, sleeves.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna hit him up.
And he's local.
How'd you meet him?
One of our coaches for flag football plays competitive flag football, adult flag football.
With him?
With him, and he designs everybody in Southern California's
gym.
He's like the go-to guy now. And so we're getting it. We've gone from flag football to baseball, and I told him, hey, I'm gonna get all other sports to know about you. $100 something bucks. And there you go. Uniforms. What's the turnaround when you order with the company?
Probably like 6 to 8 weeks. More.
You 2 months you'd be lucky. 10 days, 15 days maximum.
Shut up. Good quality.
Good quality. Short because our buddy brought the flag football jersey he has. It's thick, but it's breathable. It's really breathable. It feels light, but it's thick and durable. So the dry fit shirts that we're doing is new for him. He's never done the t-shirt dry fit. It's always the tank top and stuff. So we're the first design for him. So we'll see, you guys see how it comes out. But did you see on our sleeve as the Metropolitan
Yeah, that was sick. I actually like that.
I was like, okay.
I like it.
We didn't even ask him. He put it on there, and I was like,
it's a cool touch. Every team's pretty good. But you guys are undefeated in the league right now, right? Yeah, I like it.
All right, here we go. Montgomery still with the ball. They're driving. They're eating up that clock. It is 4th down and 2. They're going for it. Oh, that's number 68 for the Lancers. It gets into the backfield, gets a hand, and wraps the running back up, and they deny Montgomery on that play. Number 68 for the Lancers, that's Zachary Iglesias, with a huge fourth down tackle in the backfield. And with that, Hilltop takes over on downs, keeps the Aztecs out of the end zone. And we are still 7-7 here in the second quarter with 8:52 remaining in the first half. Juan Moreno from Rockford, Illinois. All right, here we go. Nones trying to take it himself. He's going to get a loss of two. All right, so Carolyn Rulberg is from Aganga near Temecula. I am telling you, I am a Southern California native. I am all over LA down, and I have never heard of that town. That's awesome. It's only the fourth time he's played that song. We're in the second quarter. All right, Levine in motion. Oh, we had a face mask holding there by the Aztecs, and that's not going to get caught. The defensive line had Levine wrapped up, grabbed him by his face mask and was jerking him around a little bit. Nobody saw it. Is Anthony Levine or Anthony Levine? Levine? All right. Yes, I know Anza. I'm gonna actually look it up on Google Maps on our computer while we're announcing. Hilltop looking at third and 12 from their own 25. Pass complete to Mason Vaquero. Hey there, if you're just joining us, check the comment box. We're typing in the scores right away and announcing them as they happen. It's 7-7. We are halfway through the second quarter. Oh, I see. Aganga is on the north backside of Palomar Mountain. Quick pass, Meza, right here at the bottom of your screen. Meza gets the ball to the 49-yard line. Nope, they're going to mark it at the 50. It'll be third down and a long one for the Lancers. Rio Nava, number four at the bottom of your screen. Nick Moore at the top of your screen. Levine. They're going to pick it up. Cabrera behind a block from Anthony Levine gets across the first down mark, and it's a Lancers first down. No huddle offense, though they're not hurry up offense. They're just taking their time. Nick Moore might want to line up on side. There he goes. Nones It's out of bounds. Picks up 4 yards. It'll bring up second down and 6 for the Lancers. Once again, Anthony Levine just hitting a head block, giving that runner a couple extra yards to get through. Handoff to number 21. That's great speed to the left side. That's Andy Bautista, running back, a junior. Haven't called that name in a long time. Started the season, was our number one running back. We're gonna have holding against the Lancers. They're gonna walk it back. They might want to move that down marker. There he goes. So it'll remain second down instead of second down at a great game. It'll be second down at 16. Known as, nice job directing the stationary blocker in front of him. He basically just stopped, jumped back, reset himself, and then took off and gave himself 4 extra yards. Nice job by the quarterback there. Okay, Hilltop, third down and seven from the Aztecs 46-yard line. Rio Nava. Isaac Mays at the bottom of your screen. Nick Moore at the top. Levine over the top, gonna get hit. Levine picks up 2 yards, not enough. The Aztecs were ready for that. That'll bring up fourth down and five for the Lancers. Hilltop trusts their defense. They're gonna go for it. Maybe they don't. They're gonna call a timeout. D1 because they went by school population, and we're at the almost bottom of D1. We're literally 23 of 23 or 22 of 23 teams. So we got, we're 8-5 overall and 4-0 in league. So we lost some games at the beginning against all the powerhouse teams in our conference, but we weren't ready to play it. Yeah. So we're playing a lot better now. Interception. We do have a flag on the field. Might be going against the Lancers, and it might be declined. And I might be Nostradamus. Yep. So we have a one-game lead. We're undefeated. Cass Park has one loss to us. It was a one-touchdown game. And they've become very good. And we've kind of waves. We play like this. We play great teams lately. and we play like this, and we play the weak team.
So you guys are better than Kazem.
Oh, we're way better. Their top player would probably be number 3 or 4 on our team. Mm-hmm. But she has heart like nobody.
Oh.
It's number 9. Great run. He's just sidestepping everybody. John Ruiz on the ground, just reaching a hand up. So, love from Juan Marino out to Damian. So, do we have the better team in the league? Absolutely. Do we play like it? Not all the time. It's all the mental game.
So even in the playoffs, so you guys, no chance?
Oh, no, we do. We can literally, if we win on Monday, we've won hands down. If we lose Monday, win Tuesday, we're co-champs.
And but I'm saying going into like playoffs.
In something. Playoffs, we can be very good because we're playing better teams. We step up. And we have the offense to do it. Most teams have one go-to receiver, one go-to running back, and a good quarterback. We have 4 go-to receivers, 2 running backs, and 2 quarterbacks. And our quarterback can hit 45-yard bomb on a bullet. And so it's like, we have it.
She plays softball?
She's the quarterback, or she's the catcher for the softball team.
Oh, okay.
So we have it. It's just, do they all put it? Beginning of the year, third month in, I'm so frustrated. I'm like, girls, you're elite athletes in all your sports. You can't get this figured out. It's simple. It's just take your athletic ability from one and adapt. And they're like, coach, we've been playing softball since we were 5 years old. I said, yeah. We've been playing football for 30 days. It takes us time. I said, you know what? I get that. I'm like, if you're here and it's open, go stand in the open. Don't run to the person and then stop. If you need to go 2 yards, turn around, not 25.
Yeah.
I'm like, this is the first down.
Oh, no, they're getting that concept now?
Yes. The last 2 days of practice.
Yeah, well, something better than nothing.
The game against Chula was we're only winning by 1 touchdown late in the game. Everyone's been beating Chula by 30, 35, 40 points. And we scored with like 3 minutes left to go up by 2 touchdowns, but it was that kind of concept, just
hit the shore outs.
Trying to get things figured out. Great run by number 5 for the Aztecs. He's gonna pick up the first down. That was Xander Thomas for the Aztecs. Great run there. So if they play and do the things that we're asking them to do, nice and simple, we can compete with any of the top teams in the county.
To me, sounds nice. So yes, it's the worst.
Paper versus practical. They're coming along. I'm proud of them. All right, here we go. 3 receivers to the left. None to the right. Tie game deep in the first half. Incomplete pass across. That'll bring up 2nd and 10. We're at 3:42 remaining. 3:42 remaining in the first half. All tied up here on the Mesa. At Montgomery High. Pass incomplete. Huge rush. That's Freddie Fleck coming in from the left side. Quarterback was seeing him, along with Juan Matus. Nice to have. Nope, that was number 19, Roman Wall. It looks like Matus is still out.
Yeah.
Is that a Matus call or is that the trainer call?
Hello. I'll try to report in the second half. Yeah, just try to finish the half.
Low snap. Deanna's looking to throw across the middle. Has the man. First down. I will tell you, Deanna has this weird sidearm snap swing of a throw. But he has it down. He does not bring it up like he's going to throw. He has it low. And that might be deceiving to the defensive backs covering. But Deanna and the Aztecs pick up the first down. It is first and 10 on the Lancers, 25-yard line. Deanna back. Slings it. Open. Beats Paquero across the field. What's that?
We got the kickoff or they
did? We did. All right, another first down. First and 10 on the Lancers, 13. Pass low, incomplete. We'll bring up second and 10. If Jacob Zimmerman was still the quarterback at Hilltop, if he was still playing, he would use one of his four downs to beam that DJ man.
He probably would, honestly.
Deanna gonna run. And that's the Lancers, number 33. Damian Moreno on the tackle. Juan Moreno's watching from Illinois. .223 and counting in the half. Aztecs are going to use the clock because Aztecs get the ball coming out of halftime. So this is a double offensive possession for them. They're going to want to use this entire clock and not let the Lancers offense get the ball. Two receivers to your left, one to your right. Play a game. Five-yard walk-off for the Aztecs. Don't know the thought behind that one. They're now third down. And 13. Third down and 13 from the 15-yard line. Let's see if it matters or not for the Aztecs. They're going to load up. Two receivers to the left, two to the right. To the end zone. Sorry. How about to the 6-yard line? Incomplete. Brings up fourth down. Might have been to the end zone if they didn't take the 5 yards. Okay, Aztecs, that's going to be number one for the Aztecs to kick. That's Dalias Garcia for the field goal. It will be a 32-yard attempt. It's up. And it's good. Nice and easy for Garcia. and the Aztecs, with 1:37 remaining in the first half, takes the lead the first time tonight. Aztecs 10, Lancers 7. Kickoff, Garcia puts it over the 20. This is Meza. Meza taking his time, not any hurry there. Maybe he was hoping that blocking would take effect. Nones looking to the side. Vaquero, are they going to call it out of bounds? They do. Vaquero got very lucky there. He cut inside when he needed to just follow that ball out of bounds and use the clock. The sidelines are your friends right now, Hilltop. The sideline is your friend. Clock stopped at 1:22. Almost in and out of the hands of Vaquero. It was behind him. Would have been a beautiful catch. But almost careened over to Meza. And that would have been a Lancer first down. That would have stopped the clock momentarily. 4 seconds ticked off. Hilltop, stacking the bottom of your screen. Moore on a quick route. Moore gets caught up. I don't know what happened. Moore was super fast starting. I took my eyes off to go here, and next thing I know, Moore wasn't there anymore. He was a good 10 yards before he got even with his player. Okay, Pablos is now back to punt. Aztecs getting the ball back with barely any time taken off. Beautiful punt by Pablos. Down inside the 25 to the 23. About a 62-yard punt. That's impressive. That is impressive. Nice job, Mr. Pablos. So let's see how Aztecs have a hurry-up offense. See how they can use the clock. 1:01. Get into field goal range. Quick pass up the middle, open, first down and more. And on that tackle, the kettle. That number 24 is skinny for a basketball volleyball player. He just got three guys to take him. How is he still walking? He's a tough kid. John Ruiz. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I would say that is a Hilltop assisted touchdown. John Ruiz dives for something, maybe to try to smack the ball away. He's laying Superman on the ground. Receiver catches it, goes. Damian Moreno swings him around and he gets loose and he scampers all the way down for a touchdown, but might be the Lancers' lucky day because there is a flag right there on the field. That might be Hilltop's friend right now. No, the players are setting up in a field goal formation, so we'll see. Surprised not one of them has the rule book out in their hand. I love how officials in high school think people can read their lips and put their hands over their face like it's baseball in a glove. See what the Houston Astros did to society? Okay, we're gonna spend about 5 minutes talking. Is he gonna address anything? Nope, and welcome to high school sports nowadays in football, where the officials forget. Oh, look at now he's going to. He just wanted to get to the center of the field. Unsportsmanlike penalty against the Aztecs. But here's the thing. Is it a touchdown? They're actually saying it was. The flag was down before the guy was in the end zone, so it wasn't a celebration type of thing. But, once again. All right, Garcia is going to go for a point after. That is 35 yards, and he made it look easy. Okay, just like that, Aztecs has turned this game wide open, 10 straight points in pretty much a minute. Have I mentioned I've only seen one solid officiating crew in high school this year? Only one.
How do you know the girls games?
He does girls games and guys games, but I've watched him for years.
Did you ever coach guys football?
What's that?
Did you ever coach football for the guys or no?
With Gritz and Reyes and Campbell. We coached Jacob Zimmerman's freshman team. We had a lot of fun.
That was Drew's first year?
That was who?
That was Weston's first year?
Yes. See, I'm trying to think. I was announcing. I announced Roloff's all his time. I announced all of Drew's time. I've announced Flint's one season. I announced the 2 years here with him. I want to say I did Diaz for a year.
A long time.
One, two, three. Well, it would be, but it's Hilltop, so we go through coaches fast.
Yeah.
So one, two, three, four. Diaz, Cody. Oh, Diaz, Flint, Cody. Drew. Five. All right, ladies and gentlemen, there you go. There is the halftime score. Aztecs take control late in the half. Montgomery 17, Hilltop 7. And we'll see you in the second half.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready for second half here at Montgomery. Pablo's ready to kick off for the Lancers. Lancers are trailing. That's Garcia with the run back. Officials say. No, nope, they're going to say runner's down. Ball stop. Woo! All right, Aztecs. Trips on the bottom of your screen. Solo up top. DeAnda in shotgun, running back to his right. Handoff. Hits to the right side. Picks up great yardage. First down and more to the Aztecs, 47-yard line. Okay, they called offside against the Lancers, but the officials walked the ball back as if it was false start against the Aztecs. Let's see. He's going to correct himself. False start, Lancers. Sorry, false start, Aztecs. He got me doing it now. We got a flag after the play was called dead. Personal foul, face mask. Against the Lancers. Hey. Let's take a good tackle way below the line of scrimmage and give him a first down. That's what happens. So face mask against the Lancers. First down, takes the ball all the way down to the Lancers 40-yard line. First and 10 for the Aztecs. Aztecs 10-16 into the third quarter, or at the third quarter mark. With a 10-point lead, 17-7. Low snap on the ground.
Who wants to get the way? No one who wants to get away. Who wants to get
That was a one-section tsunami that ended at the stairs. All right, here we go. Down to the shotgun, trips the bottom of your screen, solo up top. Now they're going doubles up top. Man in motion. T- Timeout, Montgomery. 9 minutes exactly on the clock. Montgomery leads 17-7. Here we go. Third down and long for the Aztecs. Number three in motion. Good scramble by Deonda. How he got, oh, tipped in the backfield. That's going to be incomplete. Hilltop defense comes up large right there. Wall on the pursuit of the quarterback. Hunts up. Okay. That is unlucky. Another horrible punt by Montgomery. Line drive, waggler shank to the left side. As they're running down the field, it hits the back side of the Lancers. Looks to be number five. Not his fault at all. Hits his backside, and Montgomery jumps on the ball. That's Montgomery's first down. That was a huge first down play by the Montgomery. Nice fake punt. That was sarcasm, folks. It was a punt. I'm going to have somebody texting afterwards. What was the fake punt? Okay, here we go. Aztec in scoring position. Now they're in field goal range. I'll start 5 yard penalty. We remain first down. It'll be first and 15 for the Aztecs. 8:44 remaining in the third quarter. Aztecs with a 17-7 lead. With the run. Tackle by number five, Adrian Lizarraga. Across the middle, wide open, caught. And I'm not sure about if they're going to call Grant on, what would that play be? Unsuspecting receiver? Unguarded receiver? Hitting a... Can't really do much. He's on the 1-2 yard line. They might give him to the 1 yard line, half the distance. First down, already a first down. That's what they're gonna do, put it at the 1. All right, here we go. First and 10 from the Aztec, goal line defense time. Quarterback's going to try to run. Quarterback's running. He is not getting in. Couple different Lancers there. The one holding on to the bottom legs. That was number 12, Freddie Fleck. Second down and 1. Cheering. He doesn't have grace. We are doing things we should not be doing. Okay, can they make something out of that? No, bad snap. Montgomery almost made something out of it. Third down, back to the 8 yard line. Snap to the end zone, incomplete. Aztec went for it on fourth down, and the Lancers defense, amazing job, holds them. They had a first and goal on the 1, and the Lancers hold and get the ball. That might be the spark the Lancers need to get back in this game. 5:10 remaining in the third quarter. Hilltop trailing by 10, still striking distance. Thank you.
off there. 22, Jose Cabrera for the Rams. Number 13, Marcus Rojillo. Also running the tackle, three assets, number 51, Mario Tavares.
All right, handoff up the middle. 22, Cabrera. Lancers, third down and... Third down and three, third down and a long three, short four. Here we go. And it's going to be right close to that first down marker. That's Cabrera, and they're going to get it. That's the Lancers, first down. Hand off to Cabrera up the middle. And at quarterback for the Lancers, number one, the junior, Nico Vasquez. Bass outside. And another first down. That's the Cowboy, Mason Vaquero. Court. Hit for a loss. Big loss. Second down and 15. Might be 14. Third down and 12 for the Lancers. Still behind the original line of scrimmage. Fourth down and 11. And that's about a 55-yard punt down to the 20. Thank you. Okay, we're 124 remaining in the third quarter. Montgomery with a 10-point lead, 17-7. 8-yard complete for DeAnda. Kelly's against Montgomery. They're going to walk that back. First and 15, Aztecs from their own 10. DeAnda with the moves in the backfield. He's going to pick up some good yards, about 7 yards on that play. It'll bring up second down, and what are they going to give him? They keep moving. Seven yards and a long seven. Aztecs with the ball and the lead. Montgomery 17, Hilltop 7. On the back pass, looks to the side, no one's there. Diving attempt. Don't know what the flag's for yet. John Ruiz with a great attempt right there. Let's line it up for you. It's fourth quarter. It's 11:37 remaining in the game. It is 17 Montgomery, 7 Hilltop. Hilltop needs to giddy up on that offense. Right into the defensive line, gain of one. We're hit with one-on-ones on the sides. Took advantage of it once. Tried three times. Oh, he was hit early. There's a flag in the backfield. So we have holding and rushing, roughing the passer. That'll be a first down for the Lancers. Hey, if they can't get it on the passing or running, let's get it on the fouls. Hey, here we go, first and 10 for the Lancers. Quick pass out. Rio Nava with the diving catch. It was low, it was outside. He came up with it, nice job. Nava 3 for 3 tonight. All difficult catches. Cabrera picks up more yards. We'll bring up 3rd and 2. Well, definitely pumping up the Aztec defensive line. They're pumped. Here we go. That's going to be an offsides encroachment, number 44 on the defense. Went over the neutral zone. He knows it. And guess what, ladies and gentlemen? Two penalties on this drive, both against the Aztecs. And that's 2 Lancers first down. Meza. It's a lot of running for 2 yards. All right, here we go. Clock is running, 9:40 and going. Hilltop trailing by 10, fourth quarter. Quick slant pass. And out of the hands, number 7 of the Aztecs. That'll bring up 3rd down for the Lancers. extended receiver there was Moore. As he's backpedaling, gets it. They get it right up at that first down marker. We'll see what he says. They're going to give it to the Lancers. That was some generosity there. Nick Moore down to the 9-yard line. This is the drive the Lancers have been needing. Now they need to get into that end zone. Pass, tip, tipped, and no. Tender receiver, the Cowboy, Mason Vaquero. If Vasquez would have gone one receiver to his right, he had wide open in that slot, Isaac Meza. They're giving it a touchdown. Rio Nava is another amazing catch. That ball's out of bounds. He plants his feet and stretches out of bounds, catches the ball, keeps his feet on the ground. Great job, Rio Nava. Touchdown, Lancers. When that ball left Vasquez's hands, I thought no chance, out of bounds pass. Nava had second thoughts. Pablos can take it within three. They might have had something. Offsides. Hilltop declines. It takes the point after. This center official's not really getting it today. It's the second time he's going to the wrong sideline. Why are we re-kicking? Can't we decline it? And why are we not? I didn't think they blew the whistle. They played the play. Should have just been declined or assessed on the kickoff. Did he get to move in closer? No, nothing. Yeah, it looks like nothing. Don't get it. All right, Hilltop with the touchdown. 8:14 remaining. Hilltop down by three. They're in striking distance now. All right, you know what that means. Coach Kurt Gritz and the special teams, what trick does he have in his bag tonight? Other teams hate playing Hilltop for this one reason. Special teams. But Dingle coached with Hilltop for a year. Couple of coaches. Oh, we're going deep. And another touchback for Pavlos. If he is not kicker of the year for this league, I don't know who else could be. This guy, Garcia for Montgomery, has a nice field goal boot. Kickoff's okay. Hasn't seen it put in the end zone yet. And they have a different guy for punts. Pavlos does it all. There we go. Three receivers to the top of your screen. Run up the middle, nothing but air. Untouched, touchdown, first play. That's how you respond to a touchdown. Wide up the middle, untouched, 80-yard quarterback snap. Touchdown, Aztecs. No flags on the field. No good. Point after is no good. 8:01 remaining. Montgomery 23. Will top 14. It was a day like night. A white man had you was in the streets. Trying to get some food. So I had to get some fun. Over my head. Showing up with you. Just a little sad. The world is in my eyes. I'm trying to pass this. Nick Moore at the 6, over 10, 15, over 20. He's going to be hit down at the 21. Look at this kid, 24. Right here on the sideline. Does not look like a football player.
Oh, no.
You take one hit, it looks like he's going to be up 10 down, yards.
Yeah.
And he's their punter. He's their receiver. He's got the ball in traffic twice. He got slammed and got up. The kid's a tough kid.
He's a player.
Give that kid a lot of credit.
Definitely better be playing basketball. Well, I don't know at this school. It's hard to play basketball, make the team here.
Big hit from the backside. Vasquez, positive yards on the quarterback keeper. pass, right side, way overthrown. Okay. I'm watching Nunez. He's on the sideline with his helmet on. Is he physically okay? Incomplete. Pushed out to his left side or his right side. Vasquez is up, is down, is up, is down. Something that you might not understand, it's not what the coaches are calling or saying, it's what the players can run based on the talent on the field and the success rate that they're doing it at. A lot of it gets dictated by the defense and each player's ability at this level. All right, downed by Damian Moreno, number 33, on the 40. And now we have the punter down. Yonda, flag on the play, sidearms it, that's nothing.
Ball start Montgomery. Second and 10 for the Aztecs. 9-point lead, 7:02 remaining. Low snap again. This time hit hard by the Aztecs in the backfield. Sorry, Lancers in the backfield. That's the Lancers, Gio Chavez with a big hit in the backfield. Deanda picks up yardage. It'll bring up fourth down and four for the Aztecs. Fourth down and four. With this field position, it's time to punt. 9-point lead. Weirnava back to return for the Lancers. It's our line drive punter. End over end, nasty bounces, gets Aztec bounce. This kid's punts just drive me up the wall. It takes a crazy bounce. All right, down to the 9-yard line, Hilltop will have the ball. 5:53 remaining. They need two scores. Two scores and 5:53. Quick touchdown. Onside kick. Take their time, run the clock out. Field goal to end the game. Hilltop wins by one. How's that for a prediction? Though Pablos is on the sideline getting looked at. Pass over to Meza. One guy to beat. Beats him. Mr. Meza, that hood from your hoodie you like to pull out and wear on your jersey just got used to catch you from behind. Kid grabbed his hoodie and pulled him back and it's like, would that be considered a horse collar since it's part of his jersey? No? It's why you wearing that. Well, there you go. Great tip by the Aztec defense. Great effort by Vaquero. That's what the Lancers need to do. Quick dump passes and run. Quick and run. Quick and run. Nonis back at quarterback. Quick pass to the outside. And let's thank the Aztec defense because Nonis turned backwards and would have caught the ball and taken a yard loss after he caught it. But the generous Aztec defense decided to wrap him up and give him two extra yards in the positive direction by wheeling him around in the positive. 5:11, 5:10 and ticking.
Third down and 5. Not time to take our time, gentlemen. You need 2 scores, quick. Cross the middle. It's caught. It's a Hilltop timeout. Nope, it's a flag. Is it going to be a Hilltop first down? Or is it going to be a Hilltop penalty? They're pointing against the Aztecs. Let's see. Personal foul, roughing the passer. Let's see. Personal foul, roughing the passer. Look at that. If I can call that one before it happens. Let's see if the rest of the prediction comes true. It's really nice of them not to run the clock. Nonis gets taken down for a sack. Had Isaac Meza. Big loss. Loss of 7 on that. It'll be 2nd and 17 on the 20. Quick passes have been doing it this drive. Meza's wide open. Not wide open when he stopped. Wide open when Nonis looked at him. But by the time Nonis decided to throw it, he had 3 guys on him. A quick stop route is turn, look, ball's in your hands. Not turn, look, wait, and then get the ball thrown. That was a positive gain that turned into an incomplete. Third down, 17. Here we go. There's Meza wide open again. Meza at the 5-yard line, wide open. And he was in the path, in the view of Nonis. Nonis was looking deep, and right in front of him was Meza. All right, Pavlos is limping out on the field, but he's going to go for the field goal. This is a do or die. It will be a 37-yard attempt. It's in his wheelhouse. He can make this. But as I just said, he was hobbling out on the field. Low, short, no good. All right. And that's why the world didn't end at 2000 New Year's. Because they were wrong, just like me. 4:06 remaining, Hilltop trailing by 9. 23-14. Now let's go for a new one, pick 6. We'll keep pushing until we get it. Handoff. He's going to try to stay in bounds. And Hilltop tackled him in bounds. Good job, Hilltop. And we have a timeout. Now, if Hilltop let him take his momentum to the outside and just tapped him out, we probably wouldn't have had to call the timeout. Instead, our guy grabs him as he's within feet of the out of bounds and pulls him back in bounds around into the ground.
Situational.
We had folks constantly comment on coaching and coaching and coaching. You can't. That's what the kids do. That's situational. That's football IQ or athletic IQ, depending on your sport. Yep. Here we go. I will tell you this about our football team that I'm really impressed on. They don't give up. They don't play smart all the time, don't play well all the time, make a lot of mistakes at times, have great plays at times, but if they're down, they do not give up. Nice job. That's number 88, Grant with the tackle, and we got flags in the backfield. We'll see what's going on. .45 and counting. They're going to let the clock run all the way until it's time. Also very nice by running out of bounds for us. See, even the other team does it. Should have stayed in bounds and let the clock keep ticking. Situational awareness.
You would think, right?
Good to see you.
How's it going?
You too.
Good looking this weekend.
Thank you. All right, here we go. Third down and three for the Aztecs. 3:10 stopped on the clock. Incomplete, clock stopped. There's the punt. That was a nice one. Nava, nowhere to go. Okay, Hilltop will get the ball. 41-yard line. 2:58 remaining. Trailing by 9. Quick. Quick out passes. Get upfield, get out of bounds. Get upfield, get out of bounds. Manage your clock. Nonis. Going deep. Does not have a man. Nava hooked in, the defender kept him in. He could not step out a little bit to get to that ball. Third down and I would love to see a 10-yard button hook. Take off hard. They're going to go. Turn and button. Quick pass. Takes precision. To Moore here on the left side. They're going to call this against the Aztec. Sorry, against the Lancers. I think he's going to call celebration. No, I don't know what that call is, ladies and gentlemen. If you do, go ahead and put in the comments section. He puts both hands behind his back. I don't have my cheat sheet with me. Well, we'll take it against the Aztecs. Hilltop down by 9 in the comments section. 23-14. Nick Moore's open. .219 counting. Second down and 9. Composure time. Pass. Defensive job by the Aztecs. Tips that ball right before it gets to Mesa. Four down territory. Pass, Nava to the outside, hard pass to catch, did not get it. Brings up fourth down and 9. On this side of the field, we had a 2-on-1. We had an open man. That was a hard one. Nonis was forced out of the pocket, scrambled, chose his right. Aztecs had good coverage on the right with a good rush coming at them. Had to get rid of it. Thank you. Running play. .36 remaining, 23-14. Handoff. Ball's a fumble. Aztecs recover. Timeout. Hilltop. John Ruiz could not keep his mouth closed, mouthing off to the official complaining. He's going to get himself a personal foul, and it's going to be an Aztec first down instead of fourth and 10 on their own 11. It would have been the Lancers' ball on this punt. Instead, could not control. Lack of control keeps the Aztecs with the ball. He's frustrated. We get it, but it's nowhere near the first time. Now the Aztecs can literally take a knee twice. There it is. Aztecs with the victory. They're going to let the clock tick down from 59 seconds through that play, and clock will tick down. Final score, Montgomery 23, Hilltop 14.